Let's solve this problem 325. It is said that a block placed under the head of the claw hammer is shown greatly facilitates the extraction of the nail, right? So this is that block and it facilitates the extraction of this nail from this foot. And it is said that if a 200 Newton pull on the handle is required to pull the nail, calculate the tension T in the nail and the magnitude A of the force exerted by the hammer head on the block. So it is said that find the tension T in this nail, right? So if we apply this 200 Newton force on this hammer, so then this hammer will apply a tension on this nail in the positive y direction. If this is our positive x and positive y direction, so the hammer will apply the force in the upward direction on this nail. Since we are considering this hammer as a system for considering the equilibrium, so then as a reaction this nail will apply a tension T on this hammer in the opposite direction, that is in the negative y direction. So if we mention that, so then this nail will apply this tension in this direction, right? So this is the tension which we are required to find, right? So it is said that calculate the tension T and the magnitude A of the force exerted by the hammer head on the block, right? So this hammer head will also apply a force on this block at this point A, right? So, and as a reaction, this block will apply a force on this hammer, right? So if we draw that reaction, so then that reaction will be perpendicular to this hammer head, right? So let's say that this is that reaction. And this reaction will have two components. If I draw those components, right, so one component will be in this direction and let's say that this reaction is AX and there will be one reaction, the component of this A reaction will be in the upward direction, right, so this will be AY and the total resultant of both of these components of the reactions are A, right, so this is A. To find this T and this A, the magnitude of this reaction, let's apply this condition. So if I apply that the summation of moment at point A equals to 0 and let's say that the counterclockwise moment is positive. So as we can see that this 200 Newton force is producing the moment in the clockwise direction about this point A. So we will write 200, this will be plus. Since it's clockwise, so it will be minus, right? So I will write minus 200 and the perpendicular distance of this 200 Newton force from that point A is this distance. This is 200 mm, right? So we will multiply this with 200 and similarly this T is producing, this tension T in the nail is producing counterclockwise moment about this point A, right? So we will write less T and the perpendicular distance of this T from this point A is this 50 mm, right? So we will multiply this with 50 and this will be equal to 0, right? So T will be equal to 200 into 200 divided by 50. So if we divide this by 50, so this will become 4 and this tension T will be equal to 800 newtons. So the hammer will apply this much force on the nail and as a reaction the nail will apply this much force on the hammer, right? So this is the tension T. Now if we apply the summation of forces along x equals to 0, so now if I draw a line, I draw a horizontal line here, so this horizontal line is perpendicular with this vertical line and this force is perpendicular with this line, right? So this force is perpendicular with this line. So if this angle is 20 degrees, so then this angle is also 20 degrees. So now we can resolve this 200 Newton force into its components, right? So this 200 Newton force will have one component in this direction. This will be the cos component. This will be 200 cos of 20 degrees. And there will be one another component in this direction. So this will be 200 sine of 20 degrees. So if we apply the summation of forces along x and if this is our positive direction, right, so this is in the, this cos component is in the positive direction, so I will write 200 cos of 20 degrees in the positive direction. This AX is in the negative X direction, so I will write minus AX. And this, there is no other component or force in the X direction, so this will be equal to 0. So AX is equal to 200 cos of 20 degrees. Now if we apply the summation of forces along Y equals to 0, and if this is our positive direction, so as we can see that this sine component is in the Y direction, so we will write 200 sine of 20 degrees. This is in the positive direction, and this T is in the negative direction, so I will write minus, and the magnitude of T is 800, right? So this is the T. And this AY component is in the positive Y direction, right? So we will write plus, and AY equals to 0. So AY will be equal to 800 minus 200 sine of 20 degrees. And to find the total reaction at point A, so A will be equal to AX square plus AY square under the root 2. So this will give us the magnitude of the resultant of AX and AY. So let me solve it. So we get AX equals to 187.94 Newton, and from this equation AY is 731.60 Newtons. And if we put the AX and AY magnitude in this equation, right, so then the total resultant reaction at that point A is equal to 755 Newtons. So this is the solution for this 325 problem.